Exclusive access to the after party, return airfares to Melbourne, and overnight accommodation at the Sofitel. For your chance to win, tell us in 25 words or fewer why you would like to experience the magic of Dream Lover on New Year's Eve. Good luck.
She's one of our greatest female athletes, and now Yana Pittman has a new mission to lift the cloud on what's been secret women's business for far too long, cervical cancer.
Look, it's staggering, but almost 50% of Australian women aren't getting screened on a regular basis, which is a very worrying statistic, and Yana hopes to change all that, and she is with us this morning. What a great honour to have you here, first of
all.
This is very close to your heart. You were just telling us in the commercial break, you almost had a battle with cervical cancer yourself. So tell us about that.
Look, I was a typical woman. I wasn't up to date with my pap smear because, you know, you're young and you're healthy, and cervical cancer hits people in that younger bracket. So we think of gynae cancers as being older, people over 60 sort of becoming sick. But in this circumstance, I was running at the Olympics, so I wasn't really thinking about that. I'm like, I'm fit,
is
I'm healthy,
unfair?
I eat well. Exactly. Mm. So I'm like, I'm not having that.
And I'm in my prime.
Yes, exactly. And then, I was actually in the middle of an IVF round for my daughter and found out that I had SYN3, which is literally the stage right before, that's sort of the precancerous stage. So
wow.
I was very lucky.
It been 4 years? Is
yeah,
that right? 4 years?
You know, it could have been five. So
it could have been 5 years.
So it was quite a long time because I was, you know, I just didn't want to have that test, and there's a lot of women out there like that. So I'm just out now to really encourage women that it's really not that bad. And
yeah.
I'm one of the lucky ones because I had a couple of treatments and got away with it. But I've now watched quite a few friends and patients now that I'm in medicine lose their life to this disease, and it's so highly preventable.
How did your life change, Yana, after you found out about it?
Well, it was just a shock because, again, as I said, I wasn't expecting it. And I rapidly then had children because I was told that if it was to stay this way, then I would probably have to have quite a large procedure to remove a large portion of my cervix.
Right.
And that might make it very difficult to carry a baby. So yeah. All of a sudden, there I was, a single mum, and I made that big decision to actually have my two girls by myself to ensure that I had that family. So it was a massive change in my life.
Yeah.
And as a result now, it's really led me for the rest of my life what I want to do.
How old are the girls now?
Well, my littlest is 10 months. She's gorgeous. And my big one's now two, so...
Wow.
Yeah.
Amazing. Look, we mentioned earlier then that the problem is that many women are delaying getting the test, which is natural.
You know,
But why do you think that is?
Because it's not...
It's
most women say it's not
fun.
It's not pleasant. Yeah. You don't want to go. You just don't want
right.
to go.
Right.
Yeah.
You know you have to do it,
yeah.
But it's one of those things that it's easy to put off.
That's right. And 43% of women aren't up to date, and it's actually 90% of the ladies who will lose their lives to cancer are the ones that aren't being tested.
Right.
And what people don't realise, it's literally, and with the new Gardasil vaccination and obviously with the pap testing, we can really prevent this. So
yeah.
It's just a matter of, I know it's uncomfortable, but we've got to really remind our friends and family, you know, wives, sisters, brothers.
Yeah.
To do it.
Yeah, just to get on board and
bite
get it done, because the treatment's a hell of a lot worse than the actual pap test.
Exactly. Now, you've teamed up with the Australian Cervical Cancer Foundation. So what's it like to be an ambassador for a cause that you are so connected to?
Yeah, I really love it. And, you know, if you want to be involved, I know there's a lot of people out there who've been touched by this, a family, a friend or themselves, you can go to their website, which is accf.org.au, and really get involved, and you can raise money and also... Yeah, she's gorgeous.
Yeah.
She's got a little ribbon on.
Oh,
she's a little
stop
a little ambassador too. So, yeah, no, look, I'm very, very grateful to be able to use my, you know, I guess my profile from sport in a good way for the rest of my life.
Yeah.
Yana, you know, you were saying to us before that you knew the moment when you were studying, you've been studying to do this for a while, leaving the sport, but you knew there's a moment, crossover between training and practical medicine.
Studying, just to explain, Yana is going to be a gynecologist and obstetrician. You're in your fourth year of medical school,
that's
right?
That's right.
Yeah,
I'm
so
lucky.
Way back then, what turned you?
Well, it was actually birthing my first woman. So really being in there and being involved in gyne and obstetrics. And I had to be at training at 5 o'clock, and then I got an offer to actually scrub in and be right there to help with a cesarean delivery. And I missed training, and that was kind of the sign that saying, look, Yana, you've clearly moved on to something you're more passionate about. And let's be honest, it is more beautiful than running around and jumping over things. So
you are a clever cookie.
Oh,
oh
man,
no.
It's amazing. So two more years
and then I'll be out in the real world, so watch out.
Oh, we can't wait. Yana. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Well done. Thank you. And if you want to help support the Australian Cervical Cancer Foundation and their amazing work, then please head to accf.org.au.
Do you feel gouged when you open your home loan statement, mobile phone or credit card bill? Well, if so, listen up because I have some news for you. Bessie Hassan, money expert from finder.com.au, is with me today to show you how you could reduce your bills